Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It's a great pleasure and honor for me to be here in Madrid with you today. I would like to thank everybody for the amazing work that the local network in Spain is playing and the way it's being a role model across the world. I have just had the time, the opportunity to spend a little bit of time with the steering committee, and I would like to personally thank everyone for the great work that you are doing, and of course also to the secretariat and the entire great team that are making everything possible. So, Angel, thank you very much for the opportunity to give you a brief address on how we are faring at the UN Global Compact across the world and some of the priorities and some of the challenges that we are grappling with these days. So I have been told that in year 2002 at the Royal Theatre, Kofi Annan paid a visit to Spain and spoke about his idea of creating a global compact between the UN and business to give globalization a human face. Based on that presentation, one of the biggest local networks in the global compact family was created. Today, the local network in Spain is a role model across the world, and we have grown from the 40 companies that started to join Kofi Annan when he first launched the initiative in 1999. And today we have more than 70 local networks across the world. We are close to 10,000 companies, large and small. And we also have, not to forget, more than 3,000 civil servant organizations as part of our initiative. So much has happened since the start of the initiative and also since the adaptation of the 2030 agenda at the UN, including the amazing 17 Sustainable Development Goals. And it's amazing to think about that actually today, already 3 years has passed, 1,000 days since the goals were adopted unanimously across all member states of the UN. And I want to assure you that everyone at the UN are looking very much forward to the high-level political forum in July, where Spain will be one of the 74 countries that will come to present your voluntary plan on how to implement the SDGs. So it's really, really exciting, and I think it's great with the engagement of companies that you have in Spain. So I really hope that that will be a very important part of the plan, and I know that a lot of good work has been going on in this area. So, 3 years into the Sustainable Development Goals, it looks as if we don't have a choice. It would be nice if we could pick the road of just continuing along the same line as we have been doing for many years, but I'm sorry to say, but I don't think that is an option. We are already heading on the route into the route of change. We are doing that big time. And I think the positive thing in this situation is that we have a very clear roadmap, a very clear lighthouse for the future, which is the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. So how are we faring on the goals after 3 years? They have more than 150 indicators, so it's pretty easy to see how we are actually faring. And I don't have a lot of time today, So I will give you a very brief story on where we are. It basically is that there are two major challenges that where the world needs to do much better than we do today. One of them, in looking at the goals and the indicators, is climate change. We are far behind the goals on climate change. And we are heading for a scenario that looks like a 3 to 4 degree increase over the coming years, which is not sustainable for the world. So that's a big challenge. We are also beginning to see how climate change is impacting our oceans in a not positive way at all. So that's a big challenge. The other big challenge is on the social side, on inequality. So we are seeing huge inequality across the world today, with 1% of the population in the world owning more than the remaining 99%, which of course gives a huge gap between rich and poor. We are also seeing that the gender gap is becoming bigger and bigger. A couple of years ago, the estimate was that it would take 80 years to close the gender gap. Now the estimate is 100 years. Normally, I live in New York, so I was opening the Fortune magazine the other day, seeing that only during last year, the number of female CEOs of major companies have dropped with 25%. So we are not faring very well on gender. Another example is our young people. 30% of 1.8 children and young people are not either in education or having a job. That is not a sustainable situation. It's not promising well for the future generation. So it's one of the huge priorities that we have as well. So the Sustainable Development Goals are helping us identify risks, challenges in society, but certainly also risks for the private sector, for businesses. But what we like to say at the Global Compact is, these risks can be turned into business opportunities for the companies that understand to do a transformation where they grab the opportunities instead of being bogged down by the risks. So let me show you some of the opportunities, the other side of the coin that we are seeing at the moment. So first of all, at a global basis, when we survey Global Compact companies, 75% of the companies have already started working with the global goals. That's a good start. That's very positive. I mentioned the gender gap a moment ago, but there's actually an economic upside of $28 trillion in terms of GDP if we could close the gender gap and activate women in the working market at the same level as men. The Business Commission for Sustainable Development that we have had the pleasure of participating in have put some very nice numbers to the business upsides relating to the goals. So in 4 different industries only, energy, cities, food, health and well-being, there's an estimated $12 trillion business opportunity if we take it. In terms of creating new jobs along the same lines, in a country like India, there's an opportunity of creating more than 70 million new jobs and maybe 85 million in Africa. So the global goals are also the solution to many of the challenges and many of the opportunities that we are seeing across the world. So there's no doubt that we are in for some disruption of the business as usual idea. And I have brought this photo to you from New York. It's showing the Wall Street Bull. But a very creative artist, a couple of years ago, at the International Women's Day, added this young girl to the piece of art to illustrate that we need to challenge business as usual and maybe think a little bit more along the lines of doing business as unusual. So, how can we do that? Well, in my mind, participants of the UN Global Compact are prepared really well because everyone are adhering to the 10 principles: human rights, labor, anti-corruption, and environment, and reporting on it once a year, integrating the principles into the way the businesses are run. These numbers show the latest statistics that we have from asking all our companies how they are implementing the 10 principles. It's not easy to do it. I know that from my time in business. So the numbers up here are actually quite impressive. And you can see that from 2007 to 18, there are actually some pretty nice improvements. So we are seeing a better anchoring of the 10 principles. I think the next challenge is going to be that our audiences will be interested to see what is then the societal impact of the work that companies are doing on the 10 principles. But companies are well equipped with a basis building on the 10 principles. Now the Global Goals comes along as a wonderful lighthouse and inspiration for innovation and business transformation. So up here you see the same number as I mentioned before. On a global basis, 75% of our companies have already picked up the goals and are beginning to implement them. We see another interesting number, which is that 69% of these companies say that the CEO is personally involved in driving the Global Goals agenda, which means that it's a strategic business innovation agenda that is being done. Of course, we don't know what all companies are doing, but we do have the mandatory reports that gives us a pretty good idea. I believe that these numbers even look a little bit better in Spain, and you also have more detailed numbers that illustrate that this is a little bit easier for larger companies, and small and medium-sized companies have other needs in getting this agenda right. So I think we are off to a good start, but we still have a lot of work to do, of course. So from UN Global Compact in New York, from the local network here in Spain, and from many other local networks, a lot of good tools and supports are being issued to meet all the companies where they are on their sustainability journey. I'm always so impressed when I see what the Spanish local network is doing, and I can guarantee you that everybody takes a lot of inspiration from what you are doing here. You are a real role model and inspiration to all of us across the world. I have just put up here some of the new tools and offerings that we are doing from Global Compact globally. I don't want to go into much detail with it here. I just want to say that our campaign of making global goals local business is very important. We have been doing it now for 3 years across the world through all our local networks. And, you know, when you say the same thing sufficiently many times, things begin to happen. So I think we own this space in a very nice way, and I can assure you that many of our government colleagues at the UN, other UN agencies, really like this simple way of explaining that the goals have to be implemented at a local level in the markets. They are not going to be fulfilled in the big, beautiful halls of the UN. So, yeah. Some of the interesting offerings that we are putting out are action platforms, where we combine the 10 principles and the global goals in 3-year work streams that include companies, the UN, our local networks, governments. And this is just to show you some of the important themes that we are working with at the moment and that companies are very keen in understanding better. So it's reporting on the SDGs, it's how to finance the goals, it's breakthrough innovation, it's of course themes like supply chain, climate change and so on. But the latest action platform that we have just added to our portfolio, actually last week, is a new business action platform on the oceans. The first UN event on oceans was done a year ago, and it dawned on many of us that the challenge we are seeing in the ocean space is tremendous, and we really need to take action now. For example, if we don't do anything, there's probably going to be more plastic than fish in the oceans by 50-50. Already by now, 20% of the coral reefs across the world has died due to over-nutrification and temperature increase due to climate change. So these themes are very closely related. So there were many good ways to launch this new platform on the World Oceans Day together with the Norwegian government and 30 of the most influential and powerful companies within the ocean space business. So everything from shipping to fish farming to oil and gas to insurance and financing. So this is just an example of how we develop our offerings to companies all the time. So hope to see you at the High Level Political Forum in July or during the General Assembly Week in New York. It's a very important set of forums to be present at. It seems to get bigger and bigger, and New York becomes more and more crazy during this time of year. But I think it is illustrating that the global goals are really catching the attention of the world and of the business community, which is hugely important. And you are, of course, all invited, and the Spanish local network will, of course, be there as well with the Spanish government. So let me just end by sort of reminding all of us that we now have this amazing Agenda 2030. It is the plan. There is no plan B, as far as I know. We still have 4,500 days to make the goals. It's not a very long time. As you saw in the video, we have a generation expecting us to deal with the problems that we have created ourselves. So my message to you today is we have to do like Gandhi. We have to be the change that we want to see in the world, which means that each of us, no matter what platform we have in life, what job or position we have, we have to take ownership of these goals and find ways to spread the word, to put them into action, and to make sure that we succeed. I think we owe that to everyone, not least to the next generation, and at least I don't know how to explain to my son if we don't make significant progress on all the goals, because it was all lined up and we can do it if we really want to. Thank you so much.